What up, YouTube family? It's the kid, Big Boss Fabo here, and I'm back with a video, really just discussing life and opportunities and things of that nature, you know what I'm saying? And really, I'm just, this video, I wanted to kind of talk about, you know, essentially why people give up, give up in general and give up, you know, in pursuing their goals, their dreams, pursuing specific things, whether it's a job, whether it's a person you like, whether it's a certain standard you want to meet. It don't really matter. It's just to kind of get the ball rolling and get your mind jogging and think about, why do people give up on things? You know, we gonna hop right in. You know, typically, if I'm gonna speak personally on endeavors or things I try to pursue, you know, I gave up early on things because I felt like, you know, it's all about timing in terms of like, or impatience is the best way to put it. How long are you willing to wait for something? You know, and me speaking on this, I gave up on plenty of things growing up where like some of my motives or some of my ambitions or things I pursued changed. You know, early on, I wanted to be an artist. Why did I give up on that? I stopped drawing. I stopped creating in terms of painting and just being artistic. I'm not going to say completely artistic, but I'm going to say in the drawing fashion, I stopped drawing. And that's just an example. But I feel like patience is the biggest thing when people think that they haven't acquired what they set out to do and they feel like it's all over. Whereas, you know, like at the end of the day, it's really like, things take time, things take patience. Nothing's gonna happen overnight, nothing's gonna happen quickly. So in regards to that, you know, you could have been well on your way to doing something great, doing something big, or already accomplishing your goal, and you gave up too early. You gave up too soon. And I feel like giving up is an easy way. It's an easy way out. You know what I'm saying? And people feel like when they give up, it's like throwing in the towel and a specific burden has been lifted off their shoulders because they didn't want to really deal with the pressure of having to succeed anyway. And it's very tough to deal with. You know, it feels good to feel like the pressure ain't on, but I enjoy when the pressure is on. And, you know, giving up is never a route to take when you feel like, you know, things are boiling down, or you could crack under the pressure, or the burden is too much or too big. Because I mean, everything in life has burden. You know, everything in life you could face adversity with. Everything in life, there's pressure. You know, things build up. And I don't feel like giving up is the best route to go, because some of the best things in life, the cliche, some of the best things in life you got to work hard at, and they're not overnight. They don't typically happen when you want them to happen. You know, some of the best things and some of the goals that people accomplish happen when they continue to pursue things nonstop and they never give up. And, you know, I can definitely relate to feeling like you spend a lot of time doing something and you're not, you know, reaping benefits and you're not seeing the results immediately. But consistency and repetition and all that is the father of development and learning. You know, a saying that I've heard is, you know, repetition is the father of learning. Doing something all the time is how you grow and get better at it, and you master something, and then, you know, more than likely you'll reap the benefits and see the fruit of it later on, because you've just been doing it so much it becomes second nature, and at that point, like, you know, things should normally take off. And I'm not going to speak to everything you do, because some people are chasing a dead dream. You know what I'm saying? I'm not one to really say a dream is dead or not, but a lot of people feel like, you know, a lot of people feel like, or to put it in perspective, some things aren't meant to stay consistent at or chase. And that's just being honest, bro. Like, to keep it 1,000, some things aren't meant for you. So if you keep beating a dead horse, then yeah, you always gonna hit a brick wall. But it's tough for me to even say that, because I believe in the impossible. I believe in people doing anything. I believe in unlimited, you know, opportunity, unlimited ability. And so I don't like to say that a dream or a goal that you have is wrong to pursue. I feel like anybody can do anything if you really put your mind to it. But it in reality, in some perspectives, if you weigh 300 pounds and you're trying to be a track star, that ain't reality, bro. Like, you ain't really being feasible with yourself. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of what I'm trying to say. And it's just like, Some people don't really get that, and some people aren't able to understand that, and they keep going in a direction that clearly isn't, you know, practical or yielding results. But just, you know, to put some words of encouragement out there, I encourage people not to give up on dreams, not to give up on goals. You know, I've always been a real drastic person who perceives things at the extreme. So it's like, me with things, I'm gonna do things that I want to do till the day I die. Like, I'm gonna go out, you know, that saying, I'd rather live, you know, standing up or live on my knees or something like that. I forgot what it was, but it's basically like, I'm not gonna go out succumbing to everybody else's vision or perspective or what society expects of me. I'm gonna keep doing what I do, even if it never yields results, because it's true to me, it's true to what I'm doing. So I can never be the same, or I can never be myself, if I'm not pursuing my passions, my dreams, because I'll be completely dead inside, man. And that's being buried alive. I'm not going to live like that. I'd rather live going out, you know, fighting for what I believe in, versus, you know, living a life to where it's just a facade to me, because it's not even me staying true to myself. So when it comes to giving up, and, you know, I encourage people to just stay on the road, stay on the long road, keep mastering, keep working on the craft, keep developing skills, keep staying positive minded and have a good outlook towards things, and just make sure that you are, you know, you keep the faith and believe in something. If you don't have no real belief system, if you don't believe you can accomplish things, that leads to giving up on stuff. You know, don't let people whisper in your ear about what that your expectation is, or what they expect of you, or what they think you can accomplish. Because at the end of the day, nobody really knows your efforts but you and the Creator, the person who created you, you know, God, big man upstairs. You know, He knows your capability. And a lot of people know their own capability themselves. So if you know your value, you know your worth, you know what you're doing is going to end up, you know, having a meaning, a purpose, helping somebody, benefiting somebody's life, and keep doing it. Why give up? Because people's perception and people thinking that you can't do something. So that don't really make sense to me when people just take too many other opinions into heart. So, you know, I encourage people to never give up. I encourage people to keep working, keep trying, keep getting better. You know, all you can do is take things day by day. If you feel like it's a long road, everything is a long road. Say that to a person who's lived, say that to these people that you're seeing in headlines that are living 100 plus years, or like I think the oldest man in the Guinness Book of World Records is like 118 now or something like that. So tell that person that it's a long road and you're only 20, 30 years old or something like that, man. These people have been doing things for over a century. You know what I'm saying? So, of course, life is a long road if God, you know, allows you to live that long. If you get the grace to be on this earth for, you know, longer than a lot of these people, a lot of these individuals whose lives are cut short. But, you know, everything is a long road, and that's just how I choose to perceive things. I'm not going to give up because it gets tough or it gets hard, or, you know, I'm definitely gonna have them days where I'm down. I'm definitely gonna have the days where I'm depressed, sad, questioning, wondering why. But, you know, the next day, my spirits are, you know, renewed, refreshed, and I'm ready to fight the battle and keep going, man. I'm not gonna stop. So I encourage you all out there, don't stop. Keep going. Do it till you die. Do it till you can't even do it no more. Do it till your heart stop. You know what I'm saying? And put everything you can into what you're doing. Put all your passion, your energy, all your life, your spirit, your soul into what you do. Leave it all on the court, you know, like the Black Mamba, Mamba mentality. Kobe Bryant, man, you know, R.I.P. Kobe, one of the great athletes to be known for leaving it all on the floor, never giving up and never being completely satisfied, in a sense that you want to get better all the time. You want to always learn. You want to always develop. Because that's where greatness starts to peak. That's where greatness rises and greatness develops. And the individuals who keep consistent and knowing that they never want to just 50% or half-ass, and excuse my language, but, you know, and that's something that I'm not going to say I'm solid at. It's something I'm working on. But I've been able to put that in my mind and meditate on that and grow in that sense to know that, hey, I'm going to leave it all on the floor. I'm going to do everything I can in my power to get to this specific spot, this specific place in life, and understand at the end of the day that, you know, when I'm gone, you know, I know that I gave it my all, and I'm never going to stop. You know what I'm saying? And these are definitely the traits, the qualities, and that I believe in and I want to instill in people in the future generation, you know, for kids coming up and all that. So yeah, man, with that being said, God bless everybody. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, you know, leave your comments in the comment section below. Talk to me. We can always talk about life and discuss, you know, life and things of that nature. So we out. Peace.